Our R&D strategy is really governed by three underlying principles. The first is our new business development pipeline, where we look for the largest emerging growth opportunities for us around the globe. The second is our primary material centers of excellence, where we concentrate our R&D into a critical mass, and we're looking to develop and invest in more of those in the coming years. And the final one is using technology as a key promoter of the new One Morgan. For me, it's not about just investing in new technologies and making old technologies work harder, but both. It's a combination of really understanding the fundamentals of material science that allows us both to innovate current products, to really differentiate us and get our value in the marketplace, but also to take us into new markets and new directions. And it's that fundamental understanding that allows Morgan to do that. I think with Morgan Advanced Materials being a differentiated advanced materials company, working closely with a customer really gives us great intimacy, both in terms of what's required, but also how to leverage our differentiation into their application. The closer we can get to that position, we can then generate proof data to actually show how our products are differentiated in their applications, and that truly does give us value. Perhaps I can pick perhaps three examples. The first is our fibre technology, which is roughly about 25% of Morgan sales. And we have a particular product that is a low biopersistence fibre. And that is a key patented differentiator for us. And moving forward, we have been able to push the boundaries of material science to get that fibre working at higher and higher operating temperatures, but also more extreme environments. So we continue to innovate and get rewarded for that by our customers. A second example is with our molten metal systems, Crucibles. This is the business that we were founded on back in 1856. But even today, we are still innovating that product range, both for differentiation in terms of longer life, lower contamination, and lower emission of particles, but also in terms of new markets that we can take that technology into, namely the electronics market, the recycling silicon market, but also nuclear waste management. Perhaps if I now come to the third example, which is the composite and defence systems business. This is the newest technology family within Morgan, came into us a couple of years ago. And what we've been developing is a number of world-leading technologies, most namely our body armour protection, which we believe is amongst the lightest in the world. We have also developed some innovative helmet technology, and this allows us to take the standard protection to new levels while also reducing weight and hence the burden on the soldier. Well, since 2006, Morgan has increased by over 2.5 times its level of investment in R&D, and I see that continuing. We have a very healthy product development pipeline with some truly innovative technologies, so we have great grounds to continue that investment, and in fact, year to date, we have done exactly that. Really see a whole number of opportunities going forward, both for continuing to differentiate our current products, but also looking to new horizons. We have tremendous relationships with a number of the world's leading universities around the globe. We were one of the first groups that were actually working with the Manchester team on graphene pre their Nobel Prize for Physics back in 2010. And we see a number of those opportunities coming through. And indeed, in an area of our technical ceramics business, we are working with new transducer technology to look at the advent of smart meters, and we see that as a really exciting opportunity going forward, but just one of many in our pipeline.